Let us look into the sign up form of Facebook. The cursor is currently in the first name field. Without entering data in the first name field, let me get into the surname field. We can see validation happening and the first name field is highlighted with red border. If I go back to first name field, we can see surname field highlighted with red color. The key takeaway is that validation error messages are not directly shown when the page is loaded. If the user gets into a field and leaves the field without entering data, then we should show the validation message. In the previous video, we implemented the mandatory field validation. Here we are directly showing the validation error message, but it would be good to show the validation error message if user gets into the name field and leaves the field without typing anything. This can be implemented using touched property available in NgModel object. This is a Boolean property to know if user has accessed a field or not. Let me demonstrate how this property works. In app.component.html, I am copying the existing lines that display the valid and invalid property. I am pasting it after the invalid property display. For valid property, I am changing the label as touched and the property as touched. In the next line, changing the label as untouched and the property as untouched. For valid property, we had the negating property invalid. Similarly, for touched, we have the negating property untouched. Let me save the file. After the page reload, we can see touched is false and untouched is true as we have not yet accessed the field. Now I am clicking within the name field. The touched and untouched property are unchanged. Now if I click outside the name field, the properties should get changed. I am clicking outside the name field. We can see touched changed from false to true and untouched changed from true to false. Hope this demonstration helps to understand about touched and untouched property. Now, based on the touched property, we can make changes to show the validation error message only when the user has accessed the field and left the field without typing anything. In the ngif directive, we are already checking if name field is invalid. Here we can change the condition to check for both touched and invalid. Before the current condition, I am typing name field.touched followed by and operator. I am saving the file. After the page reload, we can see validation error message is not displayed. Now touched is false and invalid is true, hence the validation message is not getting displayed. If I am clicking within the field and getting out of the field without typing anything, we can see the validation error message getting displayed now. Now touched is true and invalid is also true, hence the message gets displayed. If I am typing something in the input field, invalid becomes false and the validation message is not shown. If I clear the content in the input field, then both touched and invalid is true, hence the message gets displayed. Hope this video helps you to understand how to use the touched property to show validation error message only after the user accesses the field. Let me summarize the changes to be done. In app.component.html, include the touched condition in ngif directive, then include these two interpolations to view the values of touched and untouched properties. Check if it works as demonstrated in this video, then move on to the next video.